They are beginning tonight on the Crime Watch, and an unusual sort of Weekend in Bernie's type of crime that played out in Santa Cruz this week.
Believe it or not, two men tried to steal their friend's body from a crematorium. But it turns out they were actually trying to break into the wrong building. They really didn't have much of a plan at all. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live with more on this story tonight.
Well, Aaron, it really raises eyebrows when you try to explain what these guys did, and even more so when you try to explain or even figure out why.
It's a pretty strange situation.
Strange when two men take a taxi to a cemetery at 11:30 at night. But wait, it gets stranger. The men ask the taxi to wait while they jump a fence and then try to kick in the front doors of the Santa Cruz Memorial Park's office. Police got this call.
They're trying to retrieve their friend's body before he becomes cremated.
David Sada of Scotts Valley and Nicholas Cannavaro from Redding never actually got in. But if they had, they were trying to break into the wrong building. They were at the main office, not the crematorium. And to top that off, mortuary owner Randy Crosso says there are four sets of locked doors and four different alarms. So getting to their friend's body, or anyone else's, is nearly impossible.
So no real surprise, they weren't really forthcoming with law enforcement as to what their intentions were with their friend's body. So we don't know why they were trying to break in to take them.
And while this crime fits the bill of outrageous, it's also an insult to what is supposed to be a final resting place.
It's a sanctuary. I mean, you don't expect people to be breaking into a cemetery at night to do this kind of thing. So, I mean, there are other just sort of unspoken damages when you do an act like this.
Now, for all the kicking that happened to the doors, the glass in the doors wasn't actually broken, but the doors will have to be replaced. The cost on that should total somewhere around $2,000 or so.
Aaron. So we never really got an answer, Brittany, as to why they wanted to do this, other than to get the body, and no one knows what they were going to do with it after that.
And we asked, who is it that they're trying to get out of there? And police say, you know, they really haven't even said, who is this person? Who is this friend? Has the person been cremated already? All of these questions that these guys really haven't answered. It may just be one of those times where they had a few too many cocktails and weren't making the clearest choices, like taking a taxi. But maybe they did have some kind of plan and locked doors didn't allow
maybe
them
we'll
to
hear
do
about
that.
It. Some, but given the fact that one of them is facing a charge of public intoxication, your assessment is probably correct. Thank you, Brittany. Nicholas Cannavaro faces charges of attempted burglary, and David Sada, he's the one facing a charge of public intoxication.